favorite with a U, favor with a U, honor, even that with a U.
What job edits to make here? Chop, chop.
Good morning, New Canaan High School. I'm Harvey Duplo, coming to you live from the NCTV studio. Today's Friday, February 7th, and a day A. I hope everyone's second semester is off to a great start so far, and it's great to be back here at the desk. Right, AJ?
Sure is. That's right. I'm AJ Boyd. On today's show, the February Students of the Month and Faculty of the Month have been announced. The collaborative concert has been performed, and there are a few fundraisers going on around the school. But before we get started, please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God,
indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Let's start with our February Students of the Month. A big congrats to freshmen Cooper Jessup and Miles Groper, sophomores Dylan Blair and Alina Nasruddin, juniors Megan Leiden and David Siegel, and seniors Mark Silber and Sky Curran. And it's about time we include our wonderful staff too. Congratulations to Mr. Hernandez, Mrs. Kemp, Miss Pavia, Miss Perry, the newly retired Mr. Serafin, and Miss Walkington. Keep up the great work, everyone.
Last Saturday, NCHS hosted the Connecticut Debate Association's February Tournament, where over 200 participants from across the state competed. For NC, key performances came from Will Dathan, Naya Krishnan, and Matt Axon, who all received special honors. Matt will now join seniors Alexis Axon and John Renda in the state finals, which will take place in March. Good luck, guys.
And we'd also like to give a huge congratulations to a couple of star students, Anna Therese Mira and Teo Nelson, who were among 300 seniors across 39 states Regeneron Science Talent Search Scholars. This is an incredible accomplishment, so if you see them in the hallway, make sure to say congrats.
Last Wednesday, the National Honor Society, along with advisor Ms. Thompson, visited the Classical Magnet School in Bridgeport, where they spent time interacting with students and spent the day getting to know everyone there, including the staff. NHS students helped with classroom lessons and even worked individually with some students to help them with their math and reading skills. Sounds like it was a great trip.
And another thing that sounds good is our NCHS Music Department, who had their annual collaborative concert this past Tuesday. Over 100 students from the choir, orchestra, and band performed together on stage. Each group performed songs of their own, wrapping it up with a medley from Sir Andrew Lloyd Webber, including Phantom of the Opera, Don't Cry for Me Argentina, and Memory, to name a few. This is the only concert of the year that all three groups performed together, and they did an amazing job. But if you missed it, NCTV was there and will be airing on our channel very soon.
Listen up, NCHS, Stucco needs your help. As of right now, they have a spring dance plan for March 6th, but they still need to know if people want it. So right after this broadcast, a Google form will be sent out to all students asking if you still want a spring dance. It should only take a few seconds, so please fill it out.
And maybe fill out one of Mr. Rothman's surveys too. Also, it's almost time to choose your classes for next year. Teachers have made their recommendations and registration will be open soon. All you have to do is go to your portal page through your school email, not your parents' account, and click on class registration. Then review what courses your teachers have recommended by clicking on the pencil icon next to each class. Then select which class you want to take. Then for your elective, select up to 6 classes, and then order them 1 through 6 in order of importance. After that, press submit, then return to portal, and you're done. Make sure you register your classes by March 1st, and if you wish to appeal for a higher level course, click class registration, go to the link to the appeals process at the top of the screen, complete the appeal request by the April 1st deadline, so make sure to read all the instructions and choose carefully.
February is Teen Dating Violence Awareness Month, and the Domestic Violence Crisis Center wants to raise more awareness. On February 11th, all are encouraged to wear orange to show your support. Additionally, Talk About Love Day will take place on the 25th, where students are asked to write messages regarding healthy relationships on chalkboards and sidewalks for everyone to see. And lastly, up through February 15th is a youth song lyric contest. Take the song lyrics from either Truth Hurts, Bad Guy, Tell Me You Love Me, or Sweet But Psycho and rewrite them to express healthy relationships. Then send the song to arodwellauten@dvcct.org with your name, grade, school, and the song you choose with the new lyrics, with the winner receiving a $50 gift card. Wow, Harv, that was a lot of news. I think I need a breather.
And you want some new news? The new graphics we have, aren't they fantastic?
They are quite nice, I must say.
And you know what? We need a break, but we're going to send it over to someone who never needs a break. Oh. That's our amazing sports broadcaster, the great Ian Nicholas.
Well, yeah, it's a little too kind, Harv, but look, I can update everyone on our NCHS sports, but what about that new AAF? I mean, the new XFL, which is starting up this weekend. Hopefully this league lasts more than, you know, half a year, as I'm rooting for the New York Guardians to go all the way, or at least until the league folds. Enough joking, let's talk about our sports teams. I'm Ian Nicholas, and this is your Rams Sports Report. We start with boys swim and dive, who got a big 98-71 home win over Fairfield Ludlow Ward last Friday. They were led by their senior divers, Captain George Moore, James Ragusa, and Jackson Camporin, who all three scored more than 300 points. This was the first time in 23 years that three different NC divers had 300-plus points in a single meet. Congrats to them. Also, junior Gianfranco Pozzolini helped NC win four events. The boys just kept swimming on Monday when they beat Staples to go 4-3 on the year. There are just three meets remaining, one of which is today on the road against a tough Richfield squad. Boys wrestling defeated Norwalk on Wednesday 54-21 for their fourth win on the year. Senior star co-captain Tyler Sung got his first win on the season since coming back from injury. He's also the favorite, or one of the favorites, to win FCX again. Despite a 4-8 record, shout-out should go out to junior captain Matt Beneveno and junior heavyweight Ben Clay, who have 15 and 21 wins respectively on the year. The guys host a quad meet today at 4 in the main gym, so go support the boys after school. Now to the ice, where boys hockey has flat-out been rolling. They hosted Trumbull on Saturday and won 3-2, backed by the first two goals in the varsity career of freshman defenseman Alex Sotiros. And when you're a freshman, you lead your team against a tough FCAC matchup, and the fact that you don't even play a lot of offense, you, sir, are Ram of the Week. Congrats, Alex. On Wednesday, the guys took a short trip to Terry Connors, where they annihilated Trinity Catholic, 11-0, not a typo, with goals from 10 different players. At 11-1-1, the guys now have their game of the year versus arch-rival powerhouse Darien tomorrow at 3:50 at the Darien Ice House. So go show your support or tune in to NCTV 78 on YouTube with Dylan Pescatore on the call. If you plan on attending, though, student IDs will not be honored, as you must pay $5 for a ticket, which will start selling at 3:15 at Darien. Show up early to secure your ticket, as they will sell out fast. To the hardwood, boys basketball suffered a backbreaking 73-70 loss to St. Joe's on the road Monday, their third L in a row. Thursday, Coach Melzer and crew looked to turn it around when hosting 6-6 Brian McMahon, and you know NCTV was there, so let's roll it. It's a big news for the Rams as they get back senior star leading scorer Alex Gibbons, number 5, and they're going to need him if they want to have a chance in this one against McMahon. McMahon came out hot early. Eric Miller, pull-up jumper with a man in his face. He nails it. Here's Jawan Wiggins, John Hall right in his face. He buries for three. McMahon's up 6 at the end of the first. They're up 16 at the half. Trayvon Tweedy had 3 triples, including that one, in the first half. But New Canaan, they wouldn't be done yet. They went on a 16-2 run to start the half. Brandon Seachin got the bucket there off the Ryan McAleer steal, and Alex Gibbons was red hot in his return of the lineup. That was at the end of the third quarter, and New Canaan was able to take its first lead of the game early in the fourth quarter off that Gibbons three, the Hank Pulley assist. But Brian McMahon would snatch the lead right back 15 seconds later. Junior captain Brandon Miller gets it. The Rams, now with just a minute left, had a chance to tie it up, but they missed a three-point shot. The final score would be Brian McMahon 51, New Canaan 45, as the boys fall to 8-7 on the year, banged up by injuries. They're in a tough spot, but they have a chance to rebound and get back on track against arch-rival Darien on the road Monday at 7 o'clock. They've already qualified for the state tournament again, this time in D3, looking to repeat. Lastly, some quick hits. Girls B-ball is 7-9, losing to St. Joe's on Monday, but getting a much-needed win over McMahon yesterday on the road. Tune in for their game versus Darien at 7 Monday live on our channel, where I will be on the call. Girls hockey is still 10-5-1 despite dropping their last two games, two road losses against Darien Saturday and Greenwich Academy Wednesday. The cheer team is back at the high school for the first time in 5 years. They finished 6th in their second competition of the year last Saturday, beating Darien. Good luck to them at FCX tomorrow over at Wilton High. And finally, quick shout out to our two track teams who competed in FCX last night. The guys placed 10th and the girls placed 11th. And senior Andrew Charkalis won the pole vault. And speaking of track studs, shout out to our NCTV legends, Captain Ryan Lytel and Andrew Galois, for the fantastic graphics reboot you've seen on TMA and on Sports Today. Have a great weekend, NCHS. Harv and AJ, back to you at the desk.
Thanks, Ian. Some unexpected results there. You know what else was unexpected, AJ? All that rain that we got this week.
Yeah, well, you know, with our winter sports coming to a close, I'd sure like to see what our weekend weather is.
Yes.
Let's send it over to Amelie Lenoff. Amelie.
Thanks, AJ. This week's weather and the week and the weather for next week is looking pretty hectic. But the weather this weekend and for the weekend to come is going to clear up eventually. What's up, NCHS? I'm Amelie Lenoff, here to give you this weekend's weather. We all woke up this morning with some rain and temps in the low 40s. Unfortunately, the rain isn't going to die out until later this afternoon. We'll see a high in the high 40s, but the temps are going to drop into the low 30s, so pack a jacket and an umbrella if you're heading out. Saturday is going to be calm, cloudy, and cold, with temps ranging from the mid-30s to the low 20s. Those clouds are going to be filling the sky, so if you're anything like me and don't like the cold, Saturday is going to be a great day to wrap yourself in blankets and sleep the day away, or if you're looking to get out of the house, head over to the Darien Ice House to watch the boys take on Darien at 3:50. Sunday is going to look pretty similar to Sunday as far as temperatures go, ranging from a high in the 30s to a low in the low 30s. Sunday is looking like a great day to sleep in as well, but maybe that's just because this week has tired me out and I need it. Quick look into next week. We're going to have a medley of snow, rain, and cloudy days. Not looking forward to that nasty weather, but next week is the last week until break with only 4 days left. We've got this, guys. AJ and Harvey, back to you.
Thanks, Amelie, and it looks like I'm going to be doing the same thing as you, sleeping all day. And yes, like you said, 4 more days. Can we make it? I don't know.
I think we can, Harv, but all we can do is try. But before we go, we would like to wish a very happy birthday to Sage Hartsleaf, Evan Hayes, and John Macklin. We hope everyone enjoys the weekend. This has been AJ Boyd.
And I'm Harvey Duplock. If you have any announcements, please email us at nctv78@gmail.com. Now, we won't have a broadcast next week due to break, so it will be for the broadcast after break. Also, make sure to follow us on Twitter at nctv78. And guys, break's almost here, like we said. We leave you now with a boys hockey hype video by, you guessed it, Pablo Villa. Have a great weekend, NCHS, and I guess we'll see you in a few weeks.
He moves on in. He has Dean, shoots, scores! Griffin Dean, short-handed goal. It's 4-1. Hey, Rayer has it. He finds default at the point. Big shot, and it goes in. Pass between his legs and a backhand of scores. Carter Bain after a great pass from McDaniel. Tokyo drifted.